Let's get ready to rumble!
Well, we talked about this for quite a while. It's the battle of the giants for supremacy to see who is the giant of the new world order.
Ladies and gentlemen, now making his entrance to the ring, he stands 7 feet, 5 inches tall, and weighs over 500 pounds. Over 500 pounds, he is the biggest man in professional wrestling today. Because of his huge size and inhuman power and strength, he is feared as no other in the sport. And he is usually avoided by the competition as no other. His signature move is the one that has signaled defeat for almost all of his opponents. It is the deadly chokeslam. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Giant.
You show that very vivid power bomb from last year, and I'm sure the Giant remembers all of that. Back with Kevin Nash's intro after this. Welcome back, fans, and it's time to bring out Kevin Nash, one of the perpetrators of the biggest crime in the history of the World Heavyweight Championship, and it happened 1 week ago on this program.
And now making his entrance to the ring, he stands 7 feet tall and weighs 317 pounds. Although he is a native of Detroit, Michigan, his accomplishments and glory from professional wrestling makes him a citizen of the world. He was a member of a former World Team Tag Champions, the Outsiders, and a founding father of the original New World Order and the NWO Wolfpack, known as the Red and Black. Considered by many to be the best big man in the sport today, ladies and gentlemen, here is the master of the jackknife powerbomb, former WCW NWO heavyweight champion, Big Sexy Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash and the Giant. Very briefly, you fans may know that Kevin Nash played for the University of Tennessee basketball team here for 3 years and had a not a bad career, but had some rocky roads ahead of him, so to speak. I can use that term here in Knoxville, Tennessee.
Tony, earlier today, we talked with the sports information director here at the University of Tennessee, and he was describing Kevin Nash's athletic career and a great athlete. 3 years he played basketball for the Tennessee Volunteers, but he also talked about a physical confrontation that he had with the coach, Don DeVoe. I guess when you're NWO for life, you really are NWO for life. You have that attitude. He wasn't kidding.
He smeared him.